fascination with either one. On one hand, we have the antiquated, old-fashioned piece of writing technology, the graphite pencil. It's good for temporary writing, sketches, but you wouldn't want to use it for anything permanent. It does have the classic eraser at the end, which inevitably will run out, and you'll be stuck with an eraserless pencil. I mean, there is more pencil than there is eraser. On the other hand, we have the more modern writing implement, the advanced form of writing technology, if you will, the pen, the liquid ink pen. Very good for permanent records and markings. But if you make a mistake, you'd have to use liquid ink or start all over. But both are somewhat antiquated when compared to the modern 20th and 21st century technology of the computer keyboard, and electronic messaging. So, I mean, I don't know. Pencil, pen, teach their own, I guess. So, I take it you're looking to join our prestigious club. Isn't that correct? Okay. I would say that's great. But I and we are impartial and apathetic. Honestly, we really don't care if anyone joins our club. It's whatever, which just so happens to be our slogan. Whatever. Oh, and speaking of t-shirts and slogans, unfortunately, and I only say unfortunately as a common courtesy, we really don't care. We are indifferent and impartial to the fact that we don't have any apparel, any gifts to entice you or to thank you for joining our prestigious club. We were considering hats and t-shirts. I made this one myself, because whatever. Keychains, coffee mugs that maybe say we're indifferent about everything, or whatever, or we don't care, etc., etc., etc. But, well, obviously, we are impartial and apathetic and aloof, nonpartisan about, you know, gifts and member rewards and things of that nature. And I'm sure that's perfectly fine with you being as though I'm sure, and I'm not sure, but even before you clicked on this video, I knew. I had an inkling and a sneaky suspicion, and I still do. They're great companions. I have a friend who had a sneaky suspicion and an inkling, but not sure what became of them. I'm not sure if you have a sneaky suspicion or an inkling, but yeah, they're great pets. But anyway, I had a feeling that you were an impartial, indifferent, nonpartisan, unconcerned, apathetic, indifferent individual. Isn't that correct? Yeah, I knew. I don't mean to brag, but just had a feeling. Well, again, I would say, you know, I'm glad you're here, and I think that's great that you're looking to join, and that we have another member. But, you know, again, I don't really care either way. If you were to walk away now or click away from this video or continue to become a member. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, it's take it or leave it. But that's why I joined, and maybe that's why you're looking to join as well, to share in a camaraderie, a common spirit among other indifferent, like-minded individuals who are impartial and apathetic about, you know, being part of a club, joining clubs, and about their own indifference. So, with that, if you are still looking to join our club, we can get started. Okay, great. Well, not great, but I don't really know what else to say. There's no adjective to say. Okay, maybe not great, but okay. All right, so I just need to take some basic information. Can I have your name so that I can save the questionnaire and have you on record? Your name, you can give me your first name and last initial. Your, you know, YouTube username, your farm name, your Reddit username, your AOL chat name, your CompuServe name, your Google email address, your SCP classification number, your Arkham Sanitarium patient ID number. I could go on and on about all the different types of identification numbers and your nickname, your handle. So can I have one of those so I can save this file, make a record for you? Okay. All right. And how did you hear about us? Okay. right? Okay. All right, we are about to get started with the questionnaire. It's probably going to take about an hour, maybe an hour and a half. There are 162 questions. With the last question, I'll explain that when we get to it. Okay, so I hope you made yourself, hope you're comfortable and have nothing planned that's going to interrupt this questionnaire. I'm just going to go through each question. If you happen to get drowsy, fall asleep, that's okay. I'll just continue to ask you the questions from the questionnaire, and then I'll take any snoring you might make, any rapid eye movements, any mumbling, talking in your sleep, etc., as the answers, all right? And then I'll go over, I mean, if you fall asleep, we'll send you the results. If you fall asleep, I'll tell you anyway, in case you're just maybe resting your eyes, but you can still hear me, or you might even hear me subconsciously while you're sleeping, but we'll send you the results, okay? All right, then. Okay, the first question. Are you indifferent, apathetic, impartial, nonpartisan, unimpressed, aloof, stoical, non-biased, and disinterested about taking this questionnaire? Okay. Are you blasé, detached, phlegmatic, objective, neutral, unconcerned, unsympathetic, and dispassionate about joining this club? Okay. Are you disinterested about being indifferent? Okay. Are you impartial about being nonpartisan? Okay. Are you stoical about being unconcerned? passionate. Okay. Are you nonchalant about being unimpressed? Disinterested, nonpartisan, and phlegmatic. Okay. Do you care about masticating? The act of chewing. Are you impartial about where or when you masticate? Are you nonchalant about whether or not anyone sees you masticate? About getting one-shotted and insta-killed by lazy and poorly designed video game mechanics. Are you apathetic about lazy, poorly designed quests and puzzles that are difficult simply because they are obtuse, are not intuitive, and make no sense, so you have to rely on the internet for answers? Are you aloof about that uncomfortable feeling you get sometimes when your fingers are dry and you touch paper or paper towel, toilet paper, etc.? I'm sure there's a word for it. I'm thinking of synesthesia. Something like that, but I might be mistaken. Okay. Are you apathetic, impartial, unconcerned, neutral, dispassionate, indifferent, and nonpartisan about the fact that most of the questions in this questionnaire are the same as the questions in the other clubs. And speaking of those other clubs, if you happen to be a member of the We Love Everything Club or the We Hate Everything Club, it's okay. We are here at the We're Indifferent About Everything Club. We are impartial, you know, nonpartisan, apathetic, phlegmatic, aloof about whether or not you are a member of any other club. So, all right. So what was your answer again to that question? Are you objective about allergies? Sneezing, eyes, watery, maybe headaches, etc. Okay. And it could be about, allergies in regards to seasonal allergies, pollen. Probably should have added another question here about allergies when it comes to medications and foods. So let me ask that as well. Are you impartial, indifferent, apathetic, unconcerned, unsympathetic, nonpartisan, aloof about any allergies you might have to certain foods and medications? Okay. Are you unconcerned about spiders, especially the venomous ones, like the Sydney funnel-web spider and the brown recluse spider? About mosquitoes. Okay. Are you nonpartisan about ticks, bed bugs, and parasitic worms? Okay. unimpressed when being asked the same question over and over and over and over and over and over. Are you nonchalant when you forget your keys and lock yourself out of your house, apartment, flat, adobe, hut, pyramid, escape pod, ivory tower, igloo, hovel, cardboard box, coffin, etc. Because, quite frankly, you don't care about where you put your keys and if you get locked out, because it's whatever. Are you non-biased about long car rides? Okay. Are you indifferent about disinterested about hot, humid weather and that sticky, thick air feeling where it seems difficult to breathe. Indifferent about the weather in general? Interested about your mind waking you up too early in the morning? Are you detached? asleep. And obviously, due to your mind still having thoughts or thoughts racing across your mind, I guess you could say. Okay. Are you aloof about hitting your head on something, like if you were to bend down to pick something up off the floor or grab something from a lower shelf, and you go to stand back up and you smack your head full force on a counter or corner of a table, etc.? Are you aloof about all the ensuing pain that follows? Are you blasé about the sound of other people masticating? Okay. Objective about how long it's been since you last saw Corvus, Margaret, Dave, Professor Clemens, Kevin, Benjamin, Charlie Carl, Chris Kringle, Tabufala, Zabufala, Quabufala. I think they're triplets. Who else? Grandpa. Iggy Manley. And Bag Thing. Dr. Al Heimer. Dr. Lampert. Shade. Etc. Etc. Are you objective about how long it's been since you last seen them or anyone else at Arkham Sanitarium? Any one of the mans, for instance? Okay. Honestly, I am objective and impartial, nonpartisan, phlegmatic, apathetic, neutral about it as well. I don't love it or hate it. I'm assuming I'll see them when I see them, when they get around to wanting to see me, I guess. Or when I get around to wanting to see them. Okay, let me put your answer in here. about science. Are you stoical about philosophy? Are you unsympathetic about education and learning in general? Are you phlegmatic about seafood? Are you indifferent about land food? Are you apathetic about river food? Pardon me. are you blasé about air food? Are you aloof about waiting in line? Are you unconcerned about the dark, especially if you fear the dark, which I think is a question in this questionnaire that we'll get to? Are you unconcerned about it? There's nothing really to be afraid of. They're quite courteous, intelligent, somewhat of a peaceful race. I mean, they do have their ongoing war with the light, and I'm also on good terms with the light as well. But yeah, there's nothing really to be afraid of the dark any different than you might be afraid of anyone else. You know? So. Okay, next question. Do you care about fear, anxiety, worry, being nervous, and anxious? In other words, if this questionnaire was the same, asked the same question over and over again, you wouldn't care. You would be impartial and unsympathetic, detached, aloof, phlegmatic, neutral, and indifferent about it. Correct? Okay. Just put that in here. Different. Partial. About being asked the same question over and over again. Are you unsympathetic about the feeling when you bite down hard on the inside of your cheek while you're masticating, of course, and you're just chewing, masticating so fast, you just chomp down right on the inside of your cheek, and for the next week or so, you have a sore, a painful sore on the inside of your cheek. Are you unsympathetic about that? Okay. Are you nonpartisan social situations that you are obligated to attend, even when you are dispassionate about being there, such as birthday parties, work parties, funerals, etc. Are you phlegmatic about being outdoors? Are you apathetic about getting sunburn? Just a moment. Just a thought occurred to me. Nothing to do with the questionnaire or with you. Just a pleasant thought. So I'm just kind of zoning out right now, taking a break from this as well. Sunburn. Are you neutral about the sun? These next few questions, you might find them odd, but they're geared towards our lycanthrope members, werewolves, vampires, werebears, werekoalas, wereraccoons, werehumans, etc. Are you indifferent about wooden sticks? Okay. Are you disinterested about silver bullets? Okay. Are you blasé about sleeping in a coffin? Okay. Are you detached about wearing clothes in various clothing apparel, such as shoes? And that's, we're done with the lycanthrope-based questions. So that's a question for anyone, lycanthrope or not. Are you impartial about being stuck in traffic? Are you aloof about being stuck indoors at times? Okay. Are you objective about being stuck to glue? Okay. Are you stuck to terra firma? Okay. Do you care about being stuck in general? Okay. Are you stoical about having waited so long for Corvus's body modification treatment? Are you unimpressed about having to exert actual energy in order to do things and exist as an organism. Are you nonpartisan about something getting stuck in your eye, like the sound of a ticking clock, a quadratic equation, or the philosophy of Diogenes? Are you apathetic about having a headache? Okay. Are you phlegmatic about having a toothache? Okay. Are you indifferent about having a human existence ache? Okay. Are you neutral about getting brain freeze from eating ice cream or water ice too quickly? Are you disinterested about getting a paper cut? Okay. Are you blasé about accidentally breaking your reality.
Okay.
Are you detached about getting a painful cramp in your leg? Usually your calf, especially when you're trying to sleep or in the middle of the night. Okay. Are you impartial about your feet and toes cramping up?
Okay.
Are you aloof about having pain in general? Are you objective about being asked the same question over and over again?
Okay.
Are you unconcerned about the NWO's, the New World Order's, plans to take over the Omniverse?
Brushing and flossing your teeth, whether it's every day, once a month, once a year, once a millennium, or a millennia, etc. Okay.
Are you unimpressed about burning your face?
Are you stoical about getting car sick? Unless you're sitting in the front or driving. Okay.
Are you unsympathetic about falling down? The movie, not the act of accidentally hurting yourself.
Okay.
Are you nonchalant
accidentally hurting yourself, not the movie. Are you dispassionate about having intense, vivid nightmares? Okay. Are you nonpartisan about mayonnaise, even when it's in things where you can't smell or taste it, like some potato salads and coleslaws, for example? Are you phlegmatic about the color blue? Okay. Are you neutral about the color green? Are you disinterested about the fact that oranges are called oranges, but apples are not called reds, and bananas are not called yellows? Are you blasé about the color red? Okay. Are you detached about the color yellow? Are you impartial about the color brown? Okay. Are you aloof about the color purple, not the color the movie? Are you objective about the color purple, not the movie, the color? Okay.
Are you unconcerned about the color gray? Do you care about the color cyan or cyan? C-Y-A-N.
Okay.
Are you unimpressed about the color aquamarine? Are you unsympathetic about the color maroon?
Okay.
Are you nonchalant about the color? Are you nonpartisan about the color violet?
Okay. Are you non-biased about the color?
Are you dispassionate about all colors, including black and white, even though technically they're not colors? Are you neutral about that uncomfortable pins and needles feeling you get sometimes when you're leaning on your arm or crossing your legs, sitting on your leg, just in a, you know, comfortable position at first, but after a while you're cutting off the circulation? So you get that pins and needles sensation. Are you neutral about that?
Okay.
Are you disinterested about electronic communication, such as texting and emailing. Are you impartial about Pebble? Of course you are. It's just a trick question to see if you were paying attention. Some people hate Pebble. Some people love Pebble. But here, at the We're Indifferent About Everything Club, we are apathetic and unconcerned and unsympathetic about Pebble. Speaking of paying attention, are you detached about paying attention? Let me repeat that in case you weren't paying attention. Are you detached about paying attention, or when it comes to paying attention? What's that? You're actually on an adventure into the catacombs beneath Arkham Sanitarium? Really? Well, I would say that's interesting, but it's whatever. Is that why you have all that stuff with you? That toy lantern, that fanny pack. Well, okay. Well, good luck.
Are you unconcerned about what other people are doing, whether in your own where you live, where you work, or anywhere in the world? Okay. Sympathetic about illnesses, ailments, and diseases.
Are you nonchalant about life? Okay. Are you nonpartisan about death? I mean, everyone here at the We're Indifferent About Everything Club, we are indifferent, neutral, apathetic, unsympathetic, aloof, detached about life and death. It's whatever. Are you non-biased about never being the last to comment on a YouTube video? Are you phlegmatic about being early, always being early, and always having to wait for everyone else? Are you apathetic about waiting in general? Are you disinterested in the fact that you're probably impatient to begin with?
Are you detached about being annoyed, aggravated, and frustrated in general by everything and everyone around you in existence?
Are you impartial about having to get a shower or bathe once a week, once a month, once a year, once a century, once a decade, once a millennium, or millennia, etc.? Are you aloof about getting poison ivy? Are you unconcerned about getting mauled by a bear, grizzly bear, black bear, koala bear, panda bear, etc.? Are you unimpressed about getting trampled by a stampede of hippopotami? Okay. Are you stoical about getting bitten by a venomous snake? Okay. Are you unsympathetic about having a face hugger implant its egg into your stomach, followed by a baby xenomorph bursting out of your chest?
The same question over and over again.
Okay. Are you disinterested about the fact that there's a curfew at Arkham Sanitarium?
Okay.
Are you impartial and objective about everything that there is possibly to be aloof and stoical about in existence, except for all the things that exist of which you are unconcerned and nonpartisan about?
ask the same question over and 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 over again.
This last part of the questionnaire is more of a fill-in-the-blanks, an essay of sorts. Name some specific things that you are indifferent, unconcerned, impartial, nonpartisan, unimpressed, detached, indifferent, neutral, and phlegmatic about that were not mentioned in this questionnaire.
Okay. Right.
Let me just take a moment here to review your answers. Not bad so far. You have a couple wrong, but whatever.
Okay.
All right, so like I just said, you did get a couple answers wrong.
It's whatever. We really don't care if you got all the answers wrong or got them all right, just as long as you take the questionnaire. Obviously, we are indifferent and nonpartisan and impartial and neutral, phlegmatic and apathetic, especially about whether or not, you know, you pass, you fail, or you even give us any answers. Okay, so congratulations. You are now an official member of the We're Indifferent About Everything Club. So now, as an official member, you can join our periodic get-togethers, meet the other members, and just, like I said in the beginning, just feel indifferent and impartial and apathetic about the fact that you are now part of something that you can share your impartialness, your non-partisanness, your indifference with others, other members, other people, creatures, entities of all sorts that are just as indifferent and impartial and apathetic and neutral and blasé and aloof and detached and unimpressed about not just you being a member, but you existing. Okay? So, that's it. You are now an official member. Alright? So, now if you'll excuse